Welcome everyone to the premiere of UPW Wrestling. I turn it over to the commentators at ringside, standing by with the six men in the ring for the Storm Memorial Battle Royale.
Thank you, and here on commentary, you got here Sean Rose, and we're getting started here, like you said, with this six-man battle royale to memorialize our old friend Storm, who passed away back in February. And well, we're getting this match started here. All these men are fighting for a champion, for a future championship opportunity. And well, I can tell you this: they're going to be putting guts and sweat out here tonight, as like I said, because they are fighting for a future world championship opportunity to memorialize our fallen comrade, fellow wrestler. And now it seems no one's really taken over in this match here quite yet. This is still up in the air, no one's ball game, everyone in the ring fighting whoever's in front of them. And I can tell you, in a battle royal situation like this, you gotta have four eyes. Two in the front, two in the back. It's called ring awareness. But there seems to be a little pause here, though. So, seems to be thinking about teaming up here, but nope, looks not. Everyone back on their own end. Well, there goes someone now. That'd be AK, short-lived dream there. He won't be in the main event, I can tell you that. But now, here we are, though. Now we've got an uneven number here. So see, in these situations here, this is where it really comes in with ring awareness. We've got an uneven number of guys. Oh, and there goes out Sean Rush. He won't be getting a world title shot anytime soon, either. The bucket of elimination there. Nope, he's back in the ring. AJ Rose hitting on King Crash there with a big spine buster. Now here's Xander Rose taking down AJ Rose there. But now he's got a big spine buster there. Looked like we'd have an elimination on the corner, but not to be. Oh, there goes up and over Elijah Garcia, saving himself there, getting back in the ring. Now, four men left here in this battle royale, fighting for a world title shot. But right now, it seems like it could be pretty much anybody's ball game as we draw back down to an even number. But what I was saying earlier, when it gets down to an odd number, that's where the eyes in the back of your head really comes into play. You got to know where that odd man out is at all times. Elijah Garcia now, though, up under the rope. And Xander Rose pulled himself up under the ropes. It's a bad spot to be, but you do have to go up and over. So he will have to be pulled back in and thrown back over. But now it looks like he might be setting up as Elijah Garcia is trying to get. He's trying to get him up over the rope there, but he manages to fight his way back in. King Crash crashing right back down to the mat. And now Xander Rose is up, and he looks like he might be trying to get an elimination here himself, but that is not going to be. All men there missed wildly with that super kick, as all men kind of got bunched up there, but he missed. And now up over the rope, and Elijah Garcia is trying to get the elimination there, but again, that was not to be. All these men are really fighting tooth and nail right now, trying to stay inside this battle royale. But now Elijah Garcia is in trouble over there in the corner, manages to pull himself out of there, and now Xander Rose looks like he's about to get an elimination over here. Will that be, as he picks up, he got him up, and over he goes. No world title shot for you today, buddy. We got three men now. This is basically now a triple threat match. Over the top rope. No pinfall, no submission. For a future world title shot here in UPW Wrestling. Xander Rose has got Elijah Garcia down on the ground. Looks like he might be getting ready to eliminate him. There's a big spinning heel kick there. He's now taunting him, wanting him to get up, wanting him to get up, sending him over the ropes. But he's got Elijah Garcia with a kick to the gut there, and put a wheelbarrow-like move, putting Xander Rhodes back on the mat. They're going over to AJ Reyes, throwing him over. And Reyes fighting his way back in there as he's trying to fight for a world title shot as Elijah Garcia does a almost half moonsault off on Xander Rhodes. And now, and here comes Elijah Garcia now. Now he's got Reyes. Reyes fighting back. Doesn't want to get eliminated here. Garcia fighting back. Doesn't want to get eliminated either. But here comes Xander Rhodes saying, hey, I'm getting myself involved in here. I want that world title shot myself. Oh, Rhodes now being a little trouble there. He's safe now. He's smart move. Go to the ground. They got to pick you back up and throw you over the ropes. And now Garcia looked like he was trying to get Rhodes out there. The Rhodes fighting back. Well, all three of these men have been in the main event before. They know what it's like. They know what they're fighting for. And they're fighting to get back in it, to get back in the game, to get themselves a UPW championship title shot here in the future, near future. And now Rhodes, this is setting him up for a powerbomb. He's going to throw him over the top rope. Here, Reyes, get out of it. Reyes fighting himself out of there. He's fighting himself out of there to not be thrown over the top rope. But here comes Garcia. Garcia setting up Rhodes with a super kick, and there goes Rhodes. The title shot dreams of Xander Rhodes are now in the rearview mirror. But it's Garcia and Reyes. Garcia on the outside, getting himself back in the ring. Garcia and Reyes, the only two men left, fight tooth and nail here, blood and sweat for the for a shot to main event a UPW pay-per-view for the World Heavyweight Championship. And Reyes, Garcia up over the rope, and AJ Reyes will be going to a UPW pay-per-view in the
future.
Here
is your winner,
with a world title shot in the mirror.
When it comes to people I don't like, it revolves around one person. Guerra is a man of many words, but from what I've seen from him, I don't think he's earned my respect. I don't need two people to show that I'm strong. I don't need three words to prove I'm a threat to the roster. More importantly, I don't need to be a freak show to be loved by many. From the Devil's Bite to whatever the hell he calls his submission nowadays, he's not going to get me with any of them. All I need is one Blackpool boot, and I'm done. 1, 2, 3.
You don't own me. I'm not just one of your many toys.
Welcome back, everyone, to UPW as we got the live action down here at ringside. And here, Sean Rose here with you all, and making his way to the ring is the UPW Intercontinental Champion. And Aiden Brown, who recently won the UPW Intercontinental Championship at a live event in San Diego last Thursday night, is making his way to the ring, set to defend his title here tonight in a fatal four-way type matchup. This is a young man, young in his career. This is one of his, I believe, his third UPW Intercontinental Championship reign. that he looks like he's ready to put in the work. Welcome back, everyone, and we're getting this Intercontinental Championship Fatal 4-Way match underway. The defending champion, Aiden Brown, trying to remain the UPW Intercontinental Champion. Of course, any championship in this, or any champion in this situation, his chances of coming out, remaining the Intercontinental Champion for this title, well, the odds obviously are in a 25% chance, and probably less than that. As Aiden Brown goes to take down D'Angelo there. And now Aiden Brown, take it down. Oh, to Aiden Brown is basically take it down 50% of the men in this match. Him and Chris Daniels are the only ones up right now. But a big enziguri there to Aiden Brown as he rolls out real fast after that. And Chris Daniels now in the ring. The backflip there into a splash. And now here we go, though. Everyone getting back up. Everyone's back up now, getting back up in the ring. Everybody wants to. You definitely want to be in the ring in this type of matchup. Chris Daniels there with a big suplex powerbomb combo, and like I said, you want to be up and you want to be in the ring in this type of matchup. If this was an elimination, it'd probably do you some good to be on the outside. But this is a first fall matchup where you need to be in the ring at all times, and you need to have eyes in the back of your head like a. As I spoke to in the previous Battle Royal, you gotta have eyes in the back of your head. You gotta know where everybody else is at all times, because at any moment they could be getting pinned or have themselves in a tight submission hold. But Chris Daniels now and Aiden Brown facing off here in the ring. But he's going to the outside. Here comes KJ up from the top rope. And he's a big DDT there by Chris Daniels after KJ had been thrown off the top rope there. And now Chris Daniels and Aiden Brown, the Intercontinental Champion, staring each other down. And Aiden Brown went for the chop block there, what I believe was intended for D'Angelo, but he ended up hitting the referee inadvertently there. And I use inadvertently very loosely, as I think it would benefit any of these men to not have a referee up while this match is still going. Unless they're going for a pinfall, but as you can see, that's not the case right now. None of these men have gone for a pinfall or submission right now. And now Chris Daniels really putting in the work here, as he's basically putting down all men there with power bombs and suplexes, but now the champion there getting him. And now D'Angelo there with a big spinning heel kick there to KJ. And here comes the first pinfall. D'Angelo trying to get Chris Daniels down there. Not barely even one count there. As now, what have we got here? Looked like it was about to be an arm bar there. And ended up stopping out of it. Saw Chris Daniels right there. He's figured, well, no reason to go for an armbar there, as he's immediately going to try to break it up. Another spinning heel kick there by D'Angelo on Chris Daniels. Now the champion, Aiden Brown, trying to get a big baseball slide kick by D'Angelo as Aiden Brown was there trying to mess with him. And he said, here, have some of this. He said, you want my feet? Here you go. Gave it right to him. With a big baseball slide down on the outside, a big scoop slam there to the champion, Aiden Brown. Right now, D'Angelo's looking very strong. Missed with that big spinning heel kick, though. But KJ taking down both men with two big drop kicks as him and the Intercontinental Champion. But he caught the champion there with an enziguri. almost a German modified German suplex there to a pin, broken up easily. And now it's D'Angelo. He's got the champion now. The champion there fighting back. Aiden Brown not saying I'm not today. Or at least not right now. And he's going to hang on his title for right now as he picks up KG there for a big powerbomb pin combo. And then Chris Daniels there not breaking it up for what reason, I don't know. Now the champion in the ring all alone with KJ here. Odie tried to go for a big down close down there, miss. Big chop blocked though there by the champion. And it looks here, looks like he might be looking for some submission hold here. That puts the pressure on the back. But he's fighting out of there. Still looking to become the UPW Intercontinental Champion. That's what these men are fighting for. And here he's got him in a modified triangle hold here. And that puts they're grabbing the arm, but that puts pressure on the head. That can make you pass out. Down goes Aiden Brown from the drop kick. And now Chris Daniels with a stunner there. Chris Daniels stomping away at the champion. And now all men back up fighting each other in the ring. And they've got an illegal submission here in the ropes. He can't tap there, but there won't be a disqualification from it. And you can't use the ropes that way for an elimination. Another splash by KJ as he's taking it to D'Angelo right now. But the champion just thrown to the ground by Chris Daniels there. Looked like it was about to be a back suplex. We just tossed him with ease to the side. And now Chris Daniels moving to the outside there. Was going to try to get him off of the apron. Was going to try to get him on the apron there, but smart move. KJ got back up in the ring there before he could do that. Outsmarted him, to say. A big DDT there by KJ to the champion. He didn't go for a cover there. That might be a mistake. He probably should have. Eirik there and a low blow. A low blow by KJ. And no disqualification. But he got his foot on the rope there, so that's a rope break. Obviously there's no disqualification, but there is a rope break. If you can make to the rope, you still can get out. That's why he couldn't get submitted on the ropes there. But another champion in trouble now. Kicks out there at two. But Chris Daniels on the cover. But now he missed with that super kick. And then got caught with that behind the back enziguri by KJ there. Now the champion back up now. Wisely probably there getting out of the ring, get a little recovery going as Chris Daniels knocked daylights out of him there, almost had the pin, kicked out on instinct there. And now KJ there was going for the drop kick off the ropes, missed wildly on that with Chris Daniels. As Chris Daniels gets back in the ring though now, missing with that soul kick there. All men back up and a big arc. A cutter there by Aiden Brown out of nowhere. Two. Ellen almost had her first elimination there. As the champion gets back out of the ring there, I guess. Why waste my energy? Let these men go all fight it out. I guess that's a good mentality to have in an elimination style fatal four-way like this. Again, the UPW, for those of y'all just tuning in, the UPW Intercontinental Championship is on the line here in this elimination fatal four-way. KJ probably, I feel what he did there on purpose, super kicking the referee in the head. And that is the second time in this match, or the third time in this match, the referee has been, and I loosely say, inadvertently knocked down. But this is a no disqualification type match, so he can't do anything other than Now, I guess I'd have to try to yell at him and maybe pull him apart. But there's no disqualification here, so we might need a second referee out here at some point in this match. KJ was going for D'Angelo there, but caught the referee in the back of the head on that enziguri instead. But I guess hit the referee rather than hit the man, as he was looking like he was going to go for a pinfall there. Chris Daniels, referee can't count if he ain't up. But the referee back in it now, as he's able to get back up, thankfully. But I would think that the UPW commissioner might want to have a word with these four men, with the amount of abuse that they put on our senior referee here. And we might have an elimination in the ring. And we do, as Chris Daniels just eliminated D'Angelo there. So his Intercontinental Championship dreams are non-existent as of tonight. As we have three men left in this match, so this is turning into a triple threat now. As I said, this is an elimination-style match. So the first competitor, D'Angelo, is gone. UPW Intercontinental Championship on the line as Aiden Brown takes it to KJ on the outside of the ring, but it doesn't matter as the referee is not going to count or submit a man outside of the ring. This is a regular type styled fatal four-way, so they have to be in the ring. This is not a falls count anywhere, although it is a no disqualification due to the fatal four-way stipulation. And I don't know if Chris Daniels was trying to get him back in the ring there, but he smacked into that he smacked into those stairs pretty hard, though. But he's now he looks to be trying to get him in the ring. He wants to get an elimination off of him, but KJ's staying stubborn there. He said, I'm just gonna hit the side here instead. And the champion there looked like he was about to get involved, but caught the tail end of that of Chris Daniels' moonsault off the apron there. Got hit with the legs. It looked like he was going to put that moonsault on KJ, but Aiden Brown walked into it. They caught the legs of it as both men on the outside now are both of them getting up there at the same time. And it looks like they're about to try to team up here on Chris Daniels, both getting the ring at the same time. It doesn't no good to be on the outside. They can't win the match. And KJ getting the ring there. Chris Daniels inadvertently knocking down the referee there. Missed on KJ as he gets that back sole kick on his head. And Chris Daniels rolling out of the ring wisely there. And now Aiden Brown and KJ staring each other down. These two just were having a war on the outside of the ring while Chris Daniels was eliminating D'Angelo. And like I said, they're just staring each other down right now. Who's going to try what? And here comes, now Chris Daniels back up on the apron here. And Chris Daniels thrown off the ring apron there by Brown. As him and KJ still staring each other down. Not one man want to make a move there. But Aiden Brown now coming off the apron. A powerbomb. Chris Daniels there, he said, if I can't come for you, I'll go for him. But KJ out with a neck breaker there, taking down the champion. Throwing the champion back in the ring now. This is where he can be eliminated. And the champion, I guess, say wisely getting out of the ring there. That was a bad situation. Takes a big enziguri there, though. Now three men left in here versus the Irish Whip there, sending him into the stairs as Chris Daniels watches on from the ring. It really doesn't do him any good to get out of the ring and go to war with these men. As only a submission or pinfall could happen inside the ring. And a front flip splash there, and knocking Brown off the apron. And here comes Chris Daniels, KJ fighting back on Daniels. Daniels and KJ in the ring, missing wildly, reversing each other. Champion on the outside of the ring, and Daniels got caught there. And now into the Anaconda Vice. KJ's got KJ's got Daniels in the vise. Is he get? And he's fighting. He's fighting his way out. Daniels out of the vise. Brown missing with that cutter there. And now Brown getting back out of the ring there. Strategic move, I guess, by our champion. Real proud of yourself. Staying out of the ring. There you go. Daniels clocking him there. Can't say he deserved that. And now here comes KJ. Been thrown back in the ring there by Daniels. Yeah, you spend. Yeah, keep gloating yourself out there, Daniels. You spend your whole championship match outside of the ring. As KJ tries to suicide dive, just leaps over him. A big spine buster there by Brown. He is the Intercontinental Champion, like him or not. As Brown throwing KJ into the barricade there, as he's now down on the ground, as these two men slug it out, as he's just stomping him down on the ground. Why don't you get back in the ring? Why don't you get back in there and face Chris Daniels? We won't keep looking under the ring for weapons, because you can't beat the man clean. And Daniels now, Daniels with a low blow to Brown as he pulled, came quick up under the ropes and caught him. And now, here, you get what you deserve as Daniels throws back again, and there comes Daniels again with a flying DDT there on the champion. And Daniels might walk out of this thing as the Intercontinental Champion, as KJ misses with that kick, the clothesline missed as well. But now here comes the modified triangle hold we were talking about earlier that puts pressure on the head. Can he get out of it? And of course, the champion, there's no reason for him to break that up. But a cutter out of nowhere to KJ, 1, 2. And kicks out there at 2 and rolls out of the ring real fast as Daniels was about to get him there. Daniels rolls out of the ring. He tried to kick him there. Missed wildly with it. And a big knee to the face there to the champion. Now all three men back up. All three men still fighting for the Intercontinental Championship. As KJ and Aiden Brown here have spent, I would say, probably at least 90% of this match fighting each other on the outside. Like I've said, it does them no good. But I guess it is a strategy of some sort where, as you know, in case you make a mistake on the outside, Daniels catching Brown there again with another diving move, as he's been flying all over the place this whole match, but misses with the soul kick, fights out of the belly to belly. And now Daniels, with a roll up. A roll up into the leg bar submission hold as he's putting pressure on that Achilles tendon in the center of the ring. And KJ's not gonna break it up, as Aiden Brown sitting in the center of the ring, nowhere to go. Will he tap out? Tap out, then he taps out, you son of a bitch. Get out of the ring, you disgrace to the Intercontinental Championship. And now, KJ missing wildly with that left hand. Up, grabs his leg, up roll, Daniels got KJ now in the same submission hold as he's sitting right there, inches away from the ropes. Can he reach to the ropes? No, he can't, he's gonna tap out. And we have, and just like that, we have a new UPW Intercontinental Champion here tonight.
DC, uno, dos, tres, cuatro, free old chopper, ho! Fuck a bitch, get a bag from it, then I never call it. Nasty tripping, go. going crazy, nigga, tell her let her bubble. OG see me coming through and they say that's a baller. That's a baller. That's a nigga starting from the bottom, really in that order. Make a call, bring them pants down. Smoke a loud like some rats down. Niggas wanna come around now, cause they know me really got the crown now. Put my mask on, put the crown down, tell her, tell her. When it come to action, niggas ride with me, screaming murder. Niggas falling off, bitches falling through. Call them play like a audible. Get the money, what you oughta do? Need a plug, I can make a call or two. Put you on.
Welcome everyone back to UPW. We're set for another title match here tonight for the UPW United States Championship, as the challenger, Dylan Thunder, set to make his way to the ring, challenging for the set challenger for the United States Championship here tonight. Probably one of his biggest matches of his UPW career.
Sorry.
Well, it seems to be the whole dark society here making their way to the ring. As Kira, the United States champion, got both his cronies right behind him. But the Dark Society has been banned from ringside, so we will not see them or see their presence in this matchup, where they risk forfeiting over the title to the challenger. He makes his, and that's right there. As both men looked out at that United States title, that's right there. That's what it's all about. That's what these men are fighting for here tonight. Champion and challenger, Sterling J. Dow, as this matchup for the UPW United States Championship gets underway. Right here to start off the match, both men locking up there close to the corner. And he throws him off there. Here we go, locking back up again. Kira Dilla Thunder locking up. And Kira taking it down with that big arm drag there. Now Kira taking it to Dylan Thunder. Thunder fighting that, getting him off of him there. Trying to lift him up from the big belly to belly there. But he pulls out of it. Kira, Looked like he was going for a suplex there out of it. Thunder missing with that kick there. Both men back and forth game here to start off the match. And Irish whip there into the corner, pulls him back, and Akira reverses Thunder there with a jawbreaker. There we go. Now we're going to slow it down a little bit as Akira playing with Thunder there on the arm drags, arm bars. We're taking it to that left arm there, trying to weaken it up, maybe go for a submission on it. Is he still? Yeah, right here. This is where he plays in his game. This is where the whole Dark Society plays in their game. It's a slow, methodical pace. That's what won him this championship in the first place. Is slowing down his opponent and picking apart those arms. That's what he's good at. That's what he does. It has brought him home the title. It has helped him keep the title up until this point. And he's sticking with it. And Dylan Thunder knows that. Dylan Thunder knows. He knows. He studied the tape. He knows what his opponent is going to come in here and do. But it's one thing to know what your opponent's going to do. And it's one thing to know how to stop. And right now, Dylan Thunder, you're right there. He's putting a stop to it. It's a big drop kick up and down here and there. As he stops the pace there, just maybe for a moment. But even for a second, it benefits him to keep him off that arm, because you know that he's going to go later in this match, that he's going to put pressure on that arm, and he's going to try to make him tap. As he showboats a little here, getting back up, hits him there with a duck under, and a clothesline, and right there, right back to the arms. Thunder really messing up there, as he had the pace set and let it go. Now the reverse side of that with an Irish whip, not an Irish whip, but a arm drag there. And now Kieran though going back to those arms. Kieran now take it Thunder slowly back down to the ground as he keeps attacking the arms there. But Thunder catches him with the kick. Rolls up, rolls out, back suplex to Kira. Now kicks, the Thunder take the kicks now. Kira rolls up with a wheelbarrow stunner there. And now Thunder, now on the ground as he goes for the cover. One, two, and three. That is the first fall of the match. As he didn't kick out of that stunner there. And I guess I can't say I don't blame him. That was a big stunner to the throat there. But now Kira though on the outside of the ring as Dylan Thunder comes up behind him and just rails into the back of the knee there. So that causes him to fall off the ropes, obviously. But now Kira's got Thunder on the back as he's hitting him with the martial arts kicks and picks him up for a power driver there as he lands his head on the outside of the ring. Now Kira getting back in the ring, he's got a point up as Dylan Thunder is on the outside. He's just letting him recover, just toying with him. And Dylan Thunder won this opportunity to face for the UPW United States Championship. He's a young guy, not a lot of experience. But unfortunately, showing here tonight, doesn't have much experience, but he's, like I said, this is the biggest matchup of his life. And any man, experience or no, is not going to let an opportunity like this slip. But what is this? A stumble gets in the ring with a chair. Hitting the chair to Kira, and now just taking him away to him as the referee throws out the match. I can't say I quite understand this, but here comes the Dark Society. And Dylan Thunder wisely running out into the crowd. And I can't understand why. He would throw away an opportunity to the United States Championship. But nevertheless, Kira, you'll walk out of here still. You know, United States Champion.
My solo, please don't take my photo. I hate all you bitches. I'm clenching my trigger, I'm fucking your bitches. The grave of my trenches, trust me, you don't want it. I just hit them and kill them and hit them.
We have two of the best damn tag teams in all of UPW. And the reason I exclude Execution from that is because of how dumb and damn clumsy they are when it comes to teamwork. You see, along with Dark Society, Dark Society is a unique pair of talent with all the star power in the world. But you see, none of that's gonna matter when we step foot in this ring. Because when that bell goes ding, 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 it's time to put boots to asses and collect a W. So tonight, we prove that we are simply better and blessed than the rest. And you know I'm not finished with this promo because I have a lot to say and speak about, starting with Dark Society. You see, you may hold half the gold in UPW, but you know, there's a saying, all good things must come to an end, and that's exactly what will happen when me and Elijah King, aka the two most blessed people on the planet, aka the two most talented performers in the world, aka the blessed kings, take the tag team gold, sucker, and Execution. You know, you've had people call you a very talented tag team, but you see, that's a false-ass reality, because you see, while your partner Noah Diaz likes kissing up on non-existent women 24/7, you Alex Edwards have carried Execution on your back for ages and for more years to come, and you think it's about damn time Execution gets the recognition they deserve by climbing that mountain and taking the tag titles. But that can't happen if your partner is absolutely clumsy. So we'll give you the time to prepare for this match, because if you want to 100% when this match happens, that's your ass. We'll see you teams both soon. You know my motto. Kiss my ass, suck my dick, have a blessed day, and you fucking suck.
First tag team matchup of the night as Revolution makes their way to the ring, and Chris Daniels, the newly crowned Intercontinental Champion at the beginning of our broadcast, is pulling a little double duty here tonight, as he's also getting a tag team title shot with his partner in Revolution, as these men will be taking on two other teams in a ladder match to crown our new UPW tag team champions. Well, here comes the Execution. If 12 coming, we gonna these two men, the chase.
I ain't get no fuck.
Young up and coming tag team here in the United Pro Wrestling, looking for opportunity to become UPW tag team champions. And well, they got that opportunity here tonight as they're being thrown into this triple threat tag team ladder match mix.
Molly Sniper gon' blow like a fool. And shout out to Pop Smoke, but they don't really wanna fuck with Lil Woo. Be direct, boy, you talking to who? I got shooters that don't need hoop. If it's that, ain't no calling the truth. Why they mad? I'm just talking the truth.
Wait, slow
bitch.
It down.
Bah.
Okay, okay, okay.
Don't get no fuck.
If 12 coming, we gon' take them on the chase.
Dark Society.
And now here comes the Dark Society, the United States one half of the tag team champions here with the United States champion, as these two are going to be up in this matchup here, as they're going to try to defend their titles here in this ladder match. I expressed the word try, because this is going to be a long war for the tag titles. All these men, bodies about to be put on the line, as these ladder matches tend to get brutal, painful, bloody. But these men are all fighting for the same thing, the UPW Tag Team Championships of the World. And we're getting this match in our way, as Kira throws him into the ropes there. And now there's three teams here. We'll give you a little rundown on how this match is going to operate here. There are three teams, two title belts hanging over the ring, ladders at ringside, and the goal of this match is to ink. Basically, here at the start, it kind of starts off like a battle royal. You want to get the ring cleared of all your opponents, and you want to get and enter the ladder. As you want to get a ladder in here, clear the ring, put the ladder up, climb it, and grab the UPW tag titles. As easy as that sounds, there's only one problem. You have four other men who are going to try and stop you with ladders in hand themselves. So we are in for a war here tonight.
Oh, he goes flying off the top of the ladder there, rolling up out of the ring. Both men in a dangerous spot on top of the ladder. There goes the ladder out from under him. And a crash and burn to both of them. They're sipped up the ladder now. And it looks like the ring is clear. Somebody better get in there. Somebody better get in there and stop him. But he's trying to grab him off. But it's too late.
Darkness always prevails.
And after an almost hour-long war of a ladder match, we still have the same tag team champions as they're walking out of here. Their titles tied.
It's that scarecrow with no soul, I hold it by solo. Please don't take my photo, I hate all you bitches. I'm flinching my trigger, I'm fucking your bitches. The break of my trigger.
Whoa, 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 you're on the wrong side of the locker. This is reserved for Dark Society and his own.
What's up, Kira?
Now why did he get to go?
Don't worry about why he gets to walk in. Look, you're just a little boy to me. Your balls probably haven't dropped yet. Go to the PB locker room.
I do whatever the fuck that I want, bro.
Alright, you bet.
They thought I was taking, I'm ready to mingle. The fuck is you saying, the nigga? I do my little dancey dance. I got my pants for bands, we playing the nigga. And I don't get to talk, it's cheap. It's not when they talk to me.
A 27-year-old prodigy. Look, I'm telling you, it's good to be Sean Rose, but it's gotta be great to be Kenny Carpenter. I mean, you gotta admit, that UPW championship would look so good over the shoulder of Kenny Carpenter. He's the type of champion you want representing your organization, not some suspender-wearing, fedora-having, or leather jacket-wearing idiot like John Carter or Tyler Myers.
The second challenger here for the UPW Championship. And regardless of anybody's opinion, whether it be mine or anyone else's, these three men are about to go to war inside a hell in a cell for the grandest prize in this company.
Yeah. smoke like the onion. Cookie beat a nigga, had concussions. I just be talking the money. Me and that Brad be having discussions. I'm in mode, she ain't want me. VVS is on me, now that bitch bossy. I had to hit me a lick. You thought it was lean, but it was the tossing. Thought it was, she going to the gang, all of us. Zero for Zen, party bus. Shooters in the cut, don't start them up. Put it to the spot, shoot the party up. My pockets was low, but I got them up. My niggas don't go, ain't no stopping up. I got me some donuts, she popping up. I pull me a phone, pineapple cut. I pull me a three in a peach cut. She sipping my lean and she geeked up. The girly young Jesus is a eater. Rock it on me, nigga, don't try to sneak up. Too boring, why she think that I need her? Too foreign, bitch, I need me a visa. She staring like she Mona Lisa. Ice glaring came out of the freezer. The dumbest fighting like Goku and Frieza. No shorty, I don't want you, I need you. How you ballin', see you up in the bleachers. I'm in the stain, my niggas, they bleach you. LV, put it all on my sneakers. Healthy, smoking all the best reefer. In the ghost, looking like a Grim Reaper. On the road, she be playing like Tina. I got smoke like an onion. Cookie beating nigga had concussions.
Welcome out, he gets to step up to the plate. Kyle Myers, get a shot at the UPW Championship here tonight. His first time ever being in a World Championship match in UPW Wrestling. And here we are, get the segment away. Carpenter right out of the ring right off the bat. As Tyler Myers and, well, we're all three back. Yeah, there's all three men here fighting for a chance to hold the UPW Championship. And Kenny Carpenter taking it to him early. And now, Tyler Myers taking it back to Kenny Carpenter. And here comes John Carter, pulling himself into the mix here. This is a triple threat first fall matchup in a Hell in a Cell. All you gotta do, pin or submit your opponent and try to stay alive. Easier said than done, but it's for the UPW Championship, so none of these men care. And big chops exchanged there by John Carter and Kenny Carpenter. And a DDT by Kenny Carpenter taking down John Carter. All three men back in the ring again. John Carter flying, missing with that elbow as Kenny stepped out of the way on him. And a neck breaker by Tyler Myers taking down Kenny Carpenter. And now it's Tyler Myers who's in the ring all alone, sending them packing. Now Carpenter taking it to Myers there, and here comes John Carter out, and Tyler Myers fighting men on both sides of him, trading blows back and forth with Kenny Carpenter and John Carter. Right in the middle as both men go into town on him. And a wise move there, getting out of the way, and a big elbow by Carpenter to John Carter. And now, here comes John Carter inserting himself back in the ring, missing with that kick. Soul kick missed, coming off the ropes. And now John Carter going for a big neck breaker, and he's going to get it, and he's going to hold on, roll it up into the cross face, reverse pressure cross face. And Kenny Carpenter fights his way out of it, staying alive, keeping the match alive. Couple soul kicks in the DDT. And here comes Tyler Myers with a big elbow to Kenny Carpenter, taking him down in the corner. All three of these men teetering on the outside of the ring here. And Carpenter taking it to Myers. Carter now hooking up Myers to the big suplex through the steel cage door, breaking the chains through. And now these men, now they're in no man's territory on the outside of the ring. This is going to start to get early dangerous. It is time to put the kids away. Put the kids in the bed. And now, all three of these men climbing their way to the top of the cell. No, don't do it. Don't do it. Have mercy on his soul. Oh, it was so close. He almost went flying off the edge there. If it wasn't for, well, I want to say it wasn't for John Carter, Tyler Myers. No. But now here it comes again. The second time. Oh, thank God he didn't throw him off there either as John Carter was coming up behind him. I don't want to see any of these three men falling off the top of the cell. This is over. This is a 25-foot drop. If one of these men fell off of this cell, they would be broken in half. As these two men are teetering very close to the edge. And now, John Carter is in a bad situation. No! And he goes flying off the top of the cell. And he's got to be broken in half. And now he's trying to, and Tyler Myers getting himself out of the way as Carpenter was looking to do the same to him. They're teetering close to that edge. Military press off the top of the cell goes Kenny Carpenter. And now he's got John Carter in the similar situation. Now, and he goes flying off the top as well. Two military presses. We need medical attention down here. Seriously, somebody get down here. Both of these men taking a military press off the top of a 25-foot cell. Somebody get off their butts in the back and get out here and check on these men lying on the ground, broken in half. I can't believe Carpenter's back up, but he's got him over his shoulders now. Whittling his way out the back door. All three of these men, I don't understand how. They're all still fighting for a chance to call themselves UPW World Heavyweight Champion. And the damage has been done to all three men. This match needs to be stopped, but unfortunately that's not up to me. Please don't throw him off the top. No, he can't take it again. Another military press through the announce tables. And he goes flying off with a clothesline after him. These men, and Carpenter with a splash on the turnbuckles from the top of the cell. These men putting their bodies and souls on the line. To go back up. I don't know how any three of these men are even standing, let alone climbing back up onto this cell. Landed out on that steel beam. As all three men. Trying to make their way back up on the top of this cell. Kenny Carpenter, he misses all that wildly. Put it at DDT. And the steel is starting to break through the steel beams as Kenny Carpenter tosses Tyler Myers off the top of that cell. And a flapjack as Carter and Carpenter fly back into the ring. And back into this reverse pressure crossface. He's gonna tap, but here comes Tyler Myers with the save. Missing with that hook clothesline. And John Carter pulling it up with that dragon whip on the leg. And now all three men, thank God, are back in the safest place inside this ring as they put body and soul on the line for the richest prize in the game. And Carpenter with a chop block there. And now for the pinfall, he's at two. And Tyler Myers kicks out, keeping this matchup alive. Kenny Carpenter and Tyler Myers in the ring exchanging blows. Both men stalemating each other. Counter, good counter there by Carpenter as he hits him with the float over neck breaker. And now it's Kenny Carpenter and John Carter stare off as booking in the ring. Carter misses with that flying knee, inadvertently hitting the referee there for the time being. This match will be on standstill as we have no referee. And here comes Tyler Myers back in the ring, swinging. Kenny Carpenter all around. He's got the pinfall, but there's no referee. But there's no referee. One, two, three. And the referee was late to the show. And thank goodness, because of that, John Carter was able to make it to the breakup. Had we had a referee there, this matchup would have been over by now. As John Carter and Tyler Myers are taking it, and he's got him in that cross reverse hold crossface, but here comes Kenny Carpenter back in action. Kenny Carpenter now, taking a big slam there to John Carter as he's got Tyler Myers where he wants him, hitting him with some big chops, some lefts, some rights. And now, all three men, we gotta feel it. We're closing to the end of this match, a big back suplex there. And now Carpenter taking Myers down. He's got the sharpshooter in on him, and with all the flying off the ropes, he's gonna have to tap from all that back damage in the match, and Kenny Carpenter is the UPW World's Heavyweight Champion. Thank you for joining us tonight